Well, this is this January 11th, I guess. About the same, I don't know, about 7 o'clock now. I'm gonna go work on the plow. I guess this is part 2. The first part, you saw me take some stuff apart and what have you. And, yeah. So, we'll see if we can get the plow finished tonight, because we're planning on getting snow tonight. The snow we had last night all kind of melted, went away. We had hardly even a quarter of an inch, or half, or hardly even a couple centimeters. So may as well. So we'll see if we get any tonight. You can see there's still some on the ground if you can see anything at all. So yeah, go to the shop, I guess. Okay, well, here's the progress I made since last time. Is I friggin' made what I wanted to here. Turn this down. Of course it would do that. Just unplug it. Okay, well, what I did is I made this thing, which is just this piece here, just with friggin' that instead, so it's the same. Except while I was welding, it kind of, you can see it bent in a little bit. You can see it better if I. You see it's bent in a little bit, but that's fine. There's still enough play in those in the bolts I'm using, so. And this goes, show you a second here. See this, you see on the front of these tractors, you got the, there's not enough light. Wait until these lights warm up, I guess. Wait a second. Here you go, now you can see it. Well, they got these nice little bumpers here. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take, because this is for the mower deck, you take this off and it's got two holes here. And those are 4 inches apart in the center. So I drilled two holes there. And I'm gonna bolt it straight onto there. And that should work. And then underneath here, I have to somehow make it so I can go to those little things right here. So we'll see how that works. Exhaust pipe. So then we'll see if we can get that working. Otherwise, I should be finished then if I'm done all that. I have an awesome 65 Sears plow on my 60-something worse, early 70s Massey, MF7. Does anybody know how to tell the years on these things? Because I'd love to know the year on it. I think it's a 70-something. There's your plate, but models are MF7, model number. It's kind of funny. Serial number's really long, and it's going to be hard to read in this light, so. Okay. Well then, I guess I'm gonna have to friggin' put this little antler on there and, yeah. See if I can find my better light here. There you go, now you can see it. See the red on the bottom there? I have to take that off. So, put my light down. And then I have to bolt on the other thing there. Thank you. Okay, I got the plow on the Massey here. My battery died, so I wasn't able to show you much more what I did. Well, what I did is I got my, you know, I showed you this bracket last night. Got this bracket on there. Just bolts right into the holes from where the mower deck thing. And then I brought two bars from there. They come up to here, to the mower deck latch, mower deck holder thing. Had to kind of call, or had to cut my way around the steering arms there. Just use some safety stuff from machinery we have. And that's U-channel. Drill some holes in her and bolt her right on. And yeah, works great. Put washers and everything. And yeah, it goes up nicely. And it goes, I don't know, a good half a foot, maybe higher. And nice plow on the front now. Drove it around a bit. It works great. So if you want to do this, this is 8 inches, I don't know, 8 1/4 inches from here to here. And the bottom arms are 25 inches long. I made them longer than they needed to be, so I kind of adjusted a little bit there. And it perfectly mounts and goes around everything. And it's even comfortable to use. As you sit on her, you have your feet here, and it's just like where the Sears would have it too, right there. And it works perfect. Got it nice on an angle too, so I can do a little bit with it. And the only thing I have to do now is either make some custom wheel weights, and I have to make some tire chains, which I'll show you in another video. Or I'm going to somehow put a weight box on the back here. So, but other than that, it seems to be working good. I have to get another motor for the tractor. This one works, but burns a lot of oil. And especially when it gets hot, it starts puking out oil a lot. So, should check the oil in it too, I guess. I've only changed the oil in this tractor once, in the engine once. It's got enough oil, I guess. So, yeah. There you go. I hope you guys enjoyed this presentation from me, myself, and I. If you would like to do this, I can give you some measurements. This is from that 65 Suburban that I'm selling. So, but I'm keeping the plow. And the mower deck and the tractor are going together. I don't want that mower deck, even though it's better than mine. But anyways, this will work if you want to do that. And yeah, I guess I'll go home now or whenever and stab this video together and put it on YouTube and maybe make one or two parts. And there you go. See how long I can make this video. Talk to you guys later.